Welcome to the Wild Wisdom Podcast with Dr. Patricia Mills. I'm Dr. Patricia. This podcast is for people who want to transform their health, restore their hormones, and reconnect to their body's natural wisdom. Hi, I'm Dr. Patricia. I'm a Canadian medical doctor, published author, internationally recognized researcher, and passionate advocate for your health. Here, we'll explore the intersection between ancient wisdom and cutting-edge science, distilling the essence of true health into practical steps you can take. Wild wisdom is instinctive knowledge in action. Thanks for making this part of your day. Now we're going to be talking about the sixth out of seven reasons why individuals have a hard time maintaining their ideal weight, whether they're underweight or overweight. And I'm sure I'll be thinking of more reasons in my sleep tonight, but those were ones I definitely wanted to address. And that is the sixth one is the lymphatic system. So the lymphatic system is a super interesting system, and I'll do a separate talk on the lymphatic system one day, but essentially we weren't taught much about it in medical school. I didn't realize that because now I know so much more than I did back then. What we were taught was a very, very basic kind of understanding of the lymphatic system. And what we were taught is basically that the lymphatic system is like a drainage system, and it helps it does a bunch of different things. It helps drain toxins and kind of the garbage and the junk from the cells. The cells have their kind of garbage disposal. They use things and then they throw them out and throw it out into the water that's surrounding them. It's called the extracellular fluid, the fluid outside of the cell. And that fluid kind of gets taken up by the lymphatic system. And the lymphatic system is like a highway that where those that fluid travels through. And that fluid has breakdown products, toxins, garbage that the cell no longer needs, and it travels up into the heart, dumps it out into the blood so that the blood can then pump that and get rid of it through things like the kidneys or the liver, the sweat, that kind of stuff. Okay. So, and the lymphatic system actually helps pick up fat from the gut. So the fat kind of travels around the body in that way too. And the lymphatic system is the highway, kind of the mode of transportation for our immune cells. So our immune cells that protect us from infections and help clean up the body parts, like the janitor, so to speak. They kind of travel through the different parts of the body through the lymphatic system. Okay, and so there's headquarters for these immune cells in lymphatic system areas of along the gut called Peyer's patches. So they're islands of tissue in the gut that where the lymphatic, where the immune system kind of goes there and kind of sort of stands guard to make sure that you haven't accidentally eaten a parasite or a mold or bacteria or virus that it doesn't want getting into the body. It has to stay out of the body. And if there's a cut or infection in other parts of the body, they'll be signaled and they'll go and travel through the lymphatic system to reach that destination where they're needed, right? And we even found out in the last 10 years that the brain has a lymphatic system. We didn't know about that. And that's a fascinating story too, but the brain does have a lymphatic system as well. And what happens is that when there is, when the lymphatic system starts to fail, it no longer is transporting this fluid. And so that fluid that's being, that's around the cells, the extracellular fluid doesn't have a way of being drained out and it starts to accumulate. And so some people will start to kind of get bigger and heavier. And it's actually this fluid that's kind of accumulating in their tissues. So there's the tissue is getting thicker. And there's a tip for knowing if that's the case with you is if you press the tissue with your thumb and there's a thumbprint left behind and slowly that thumbprint goes away, but you can see the imprint of your thumb. And that's a sign that you have what's called edema, swelling as a result of the lymphatic system not functioning properly and not clearing the fluid from your limbs, like your legs and your arms and that kind of stuff. And, the lymphatic system has lymphatic nodes, and people are familiar with the lymphatic nodes when it comes to cancer. If you have cancer in your lymph nodes, for example, from breast cancer, they'll go in and remove the lymph nodes if the breast cancer has traveled to the lymph nodes. And what those individuals get is on the side where the lymph nodes were removed, the arm gets swollen. and full of kind of water, you know, this lymphatic tissue. It's not water because it also contains all of those breakdown products that the cell is dumping out. So that's why you get like the kind of indenting of the skin, because it's like a different kind of water. It's not like water retention that you get from inflammation, where the skin is still kind of like springy and springs back when you put your thumb in. It's like the skin is kind of like indented, like soggy and indented. And so some people put on weight, in this unique kind of way, and that's from lymphatic congestion. And the reasons for that are multifold. It relates a bit to that toxins tipping point, because toxins are carried through the lymphatic system. It can be due to, again, digestive issues. So you're not properly breaking down your fats and your proteins, and that's starting to clog up your lymphatic system. So there's a number of different ways, but that's one reason. So you have to, again, one of the things I really work with my clients is helping them move the lymphatic system and decongest the lymphatic system. And there are very well-researched ways to do so, like rebounding and, again, infrared sauna and other things that can be very powerful to help that lymphatic system kind of drain itself out.
Thank you for taking the time to listen to this podcast, Wild Wisdom with Dr. Patricia Mills. If you like this podcast, please take the time to like and subscribe, and please feel free to leave any comments and look below for the contact information if you want to connect with me directly. Thank you, and I hope you have a wonderful day, evening, or night.
Hi, everyone. I hope you enjoyed this episode. Just a reminder, this podcast is for educational purposes only. This podcast is not a substitute for a professional care doctor or other qualified medical professional. This podcast is provided with the understanding that it does not constitute medical or other professional advice or services. If you are looking for help in your journey, it is important that you seek out a qualified health practitioner. If you would like to work with Dr. Patricia for her expert health transformation guidance, please email her at info@drpatriciamills.com to book a discovery call. You can also find Dr. Patricia on Instagram at Dr. Patricia Mills and Facebook at Wild Wisdom for Women with Dr. Patricia Mills, MD. For access to all of Dr. Patricia's educational videos and more amazing perks, consider becoming a Patreon member. Links are in the description of this episode. It is important to have an expert in your corner that can help you make the changes you crave, especially when it comes to your health.